Hi everyone, I'm Ashok Kumar. In this episode, let's learn integrating Twitter API for our Android application. Twitter API as in login with Twitter, search tweets, hashtag and Twitter feeds. So how do we do it? So Twitter has an easiest and surprisingly simple solution called Fabric SDK. What this Fabric SDK does, it takes away all the development time for developers and it codes on its own for ease the thing around for developer. So let's get started. If you are a first time user, the URL you need to go would be get.fabric.io. This is the URL that you are supposed to go where you will be getting Twitter to integrate with your Android Studio or IntelliJ IDEA, or it could be Eclipse ADT, and it goes same in any platform. Even if you are an Windows user, Linux user, or Apple Macintosh user, everything goes same. I have downloaded my plugin as already. It is about 28 MB plugin, Fabric Android Studio plugin. Just go to your Android Studio preferences, and go to plugins in the preferences. Once it loads, and then install the plugin from disk and navigate to the location that you have downloaded the plugin, and that's it. Once plugin is installed, then we are good to go and start creating our Android project. So let's name our project as Twitter Fun, and my company domain would be ashokslsk.com, and my package address would be com.ashokslsk.twitterfun. It's reverse order. And next, I will create a minimum API level of 16, which is 4.1 Jelly Bean, and I'll leave it to the blank screen, blank activity. So that's it. So it takes about 20 seconds to create Cradle and syncs up. Once your project creation is completed, it'll show all the classes, which is main activity and a manifest and Cradle. And this is the basic application creation, nothing big. We can make out whether Fabric SDK is configured inside our Android Studio or IntelliJ IDEA or Eclipse by checking this icon called Fabric. This icon. So let's get started. So I have already a couple of projects workspace in the Twitter remote where I have already used Twitter login and Twitter search APIs. So let's not do that. And this Twitter kit searches for whether the current project had already integrated Crashlytics, Twitter login and Twitter embedded feeds and hashtags and digits, Mopub. Mopub is an again advertisement platform where you can monetize your app with the Twitter ad campaigns. So we are interested in this video to create Twitter login and searching tweets. So let's install Twitter into the current app. So that's it. It's simple steps. Login with Twitter. So you will click on the apply. So you can see the changes in Android Studio. Like your Gradle gets modified automatically and Fabric SDK suggests use this Twitter login button to your relative layout, which is main layout. So let's copy this. So once Twitter has configured this project with the Fabric SDK. Just copy this login button and you can drag and drop to your XML just like this, and copy this into your relative layout or linear layout container. So once it's been copied, map that XML component with the Java code. Twitter login button, we'll call it as login button, and using the viewfinder methods like find view by ID, I will map this Java Twitter login button object to my XML view. I need to cast it. That's it. So this is mapped to our activity main XML, which is Twitter button. So once it is compiled, you'll get to know how does this Twitter login button looks. So after this, we need to call a method called set callback. And inside of that, we need to call new callback Twitter session methods, and that generates two extra methods, which is public void success, which gives Twitter session object, on failure, which returns Twitter exception object. So once it is success, so create string username. Use this result object and get username with the result.data.getUsername method. So then you can toast the same once it is successful login. So that's it. It is not complete yet. You need to call on result activity result method. This method, basically, what it does, once it calls the Twitter servers, it requests the server authentication code and gives us the authentication token through a network stream, and that is being handled in onActivityResult method that can be called here. So okay, now we are good to go. So let's compile it in the running device. So once compilation is completed, it will ask choose the running device and choose the running device. So I have real device running in my POM and which has been projected in the device. So you can see well-crafted login with the Twitter button, and this is our project. If we press on that, it will go to Twitter servers for the authorization. So if you have account, you can type it. Yes, it's been authorized. As simple as it is. Please do watch next episode, which uses the same project for searching the feeds in the action bar search. Please do subscribe for our channel and please do like our videos. Thank you.